So the respiratory system is called down. It consists of mouth, buccal cavity and the pharynx. So this diagram, it shows the respiratory system in scolodon. So gill lamina, gill septum, gill pouch, basibranchial cartilage. Okay, so here you can see gill lamina, gill septum and gill pouch. Again, afferent branchial artery and cerebrobranchial cartilage and vessel and capillaries of the gill lamina. Okay, so gill lamellae, gill septum and the gill pouch. Next is, so you can see here the respiratory system, it consists of first one is mouth. So it consists of the mouth. You can see here the mouth closed, lower jaw and the buccal cavity. You can see this portion is a mouth and then the buccal cavity, and this portion is known as pharynx. So the respiratory system is consists of, that is, mouth, buccal cavity and the pharynx. Okay, after that you can see there are gill lamellae. Okay, you can see here the 1, 2, 3, 4 gill lamellae are there, and these gill lamellae are hollow branch. Hollow means complete. You can see here the structure like this. Okay, so this is the hollow branch gill lamellae, and you can see here this one is hemi branch, hemi or the demi branch. Okay, so you can see here only half is present. Okay, only half side of the gill lamellae is present. So you can see here 1/5 open gill slits are there, and the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the sixth one, you can see here the sixth one is gillless. Okay, so you can see here the interbranchial septum. Okay, so interbranchial septum. So this portion is known as interbranchial septum. Okay, so this is about the respiratory system of scolodon. Okay, so now respiration is aquatic. As we know that the gills for the aquatic respiration, water enters through well-developed passage called as respiratory tract. Again, the mouth is present on the ventral side of the head that leads to the buccal cavity, and water passes behind into the pharynx through the respiratory tract, water conveyed to the gill. Now we are going to study the in detail of the gill. So this portion is known as interbranchial septum. Okay, and these are the extrabranchial cartilage. This is the anterior gill lamina. So this portion is anterior gill lamina, and this one is the posterior. This one is the posterior gill lamina. So anterior is smaller than the posterior. Posterior is a larger. Okay. Again, you can see afferent branchial artery and post-traumatic nerve as well as branchial ring. Okay. So now the respiratory organ. As we know that there are 5 pairs of gill pouches or the hollow branches. Okay. So each branchial pouch communicates with the pharynx. So this is the gill lamina. This is the branchial pouch. So this portion, this blank portion, is known as branchial pouch. Okay. So this branchial pouch communicates with the pharynx. So this portion is known as pharynx, and this branchial pouch communicates with the pharynx. So the interbranchial septa touts the partition separate the successive branchial pouches. Now the internal interbranchial septa, so this portion, as we know that, so this is the this interbranchial septa having a fibromuscular tissue covered by the mucous membrane and cuboidal epithelial cell and contains blood vessels and the nerve fiber. As we know that hemi branch, as we know the hemi means half, contains, okay, and hollow branch is there. This is the branchial pouch. The distance between two is known as branchial pouch. You can see here the hemi branch, only the half, the having the half gill or the only one gill is known as hemi branch or the demi branch, and this is the branchial pouch. A series of thin, highly muscular horizontal fold called a branchial lamellae, and that is originate from the mucous membrane of branchial pouches. So two sets of lamellae are present, that is interior and the posterior side of the interbranchial septum. As we know that two sets originated from the same interbranchial septum forms a complete and or the hollow branch, as we know that. Okay. Complete or the hollow branch origin first for branchial arches. A single set of branchial lamellae is known as half gill, demi branch or the hemi branch. If only one is present is known as hemi branch, demi branch, and if the both are present known as, that is, hollow branch. Origin is posterior face of haloid arch, and fifth arch is a gillus. Fifth or the sixth arch is a gillus. After that, afferent branchial artery that innervates gills and the branchial lamella. The oxygenation of blood takes place while passing through the sinusoids. Each interbranchial septum, it is supported by vertical and the horizontal muscles. Now, the respiration in scolodon. Most sharks have to keep moving to move water over their gills. So, the water enters the gill chamber through the mouth or the spiracle and exit through the gill slits. So, blood in the gill filaments absorb the oxygen from the incoming water. You can see here in this diagram. So the water that enters through the mouth and exit through the, that is, gill septum. You can see there is an afferent branchial artery and the efferent branchial artery. Afferent branchial artery is blue in color. It carries deoxygenated blood, and efferent branchial artery is red in color, that carries the oxygenated blood. Okay. Next, you can see here the lateral view, that is afferent branchial arteries and efferent branchial arteries. As we know that afferent branchial artery, it carries the deoxygenated blood, and efferent one is carries oxygenated blood. Now you can see the gill arches, heart and the ventral aorta. Okay, here the mouth is open. When mouth is open, water enters through the mouth. Okay, that is inhalation of the water. Okay, so buccal chamber is expanding at that time. Again, operculum wall are closed, and these are the gill arches. When the mouth closes, buccal chamber contracts and the operculum wall open. As we know that, so the inhalation and exhalation process, as we know that the gill lamella has extensive system of sinusoids which receives the venous blood from all afferent branchial artery, as we know that, and it passes into an efferent or the epibranchial artery. During this passage of the blood through his network, it becomes oxygenated, as we know that. The fresh sea water enters through the gill pouches. Okay, so fresh water that enters through the gill pouches in the gill chamber, as we know that, and contains dissolved oxygen in it. So this dissolved oxygen, it passes by diffusion through this thin membrane, permeable capillary wall, into a blood. At the same time, that is, carbon dioxide of the venous blood passes out by diffusion into outgoing water current. This process is known as external respiration or exhalation. Okay, it's oxygen is used by tissue to oxidize foodstuffs, and carbon dioxide thus formed is surrendered to the blood, which again becomes venous. This process is known as internal respiration. You can see here in this diagram, buccal Okay, so inspiration, as we already know that when the mouth open, gill arches expand to the wall of buccal and the pharyngeal cavity, pressure reduced in the buccal and the pharyngeal cavity, then water enters to the mouth, the external branchial aperture went to the waters outside the water entry, mouth is closed, water pressure is increases in the buccopharyngeal cavity at the time of expiration. Expel the water through the branchial pouches during the expiration, the esophagus is totally closed. So here in this colidon, as we know that you can see in this diagram, okay, here in this colidon, this diagram shows inspiration and this one is expiration. Okay, so the heart, so this type of respiration in this colidon is known as, that is, a single type of respiration, because the heart, it only contains the venous blood or the deoxygenated blood, or it is also called as a single type of circulation. Only the exchange of oxygenated blood takes place in gill. Okay, and heart, it contains the deoxygenated blood, also known as venous, that is a single type of circulation. Okay, in this heart, or it is also called as venous heart or the venous blood, because it receives only deoxygenated blood, that's why. Thank you.